couple days ago, news arrived in Canada that a bank in Denmark was giving away 20-year fixed mortgage rates for 0.00%. Yeah, you heard me right, that a mortgage borrower could borrow for two entire decades and not spend a dollar in interest. Naturally, the reactions by Canadians were one of confusion. Some were even enthusiastic that someday they may be able to see that rate in Canada, but most just wanted to know how. Well, Jonah Hart, let's answer that for you. Hey everyone, I'm Conrad Neufelty, nationally award-winning mortgage broker up here in Canada, and today we're talking about Nordea Bank's 20-year fixed 0% mortgage that they're giving away in Denmark. Anyone who follows interest rates, even loosely in North America, knows that a 0% mortgage rate is a friggin' good deal. I mean, in America, the closest thing that they have right now is a 20-year fixed mortgage, and that's at 2.75%. And Canadians, well, we don't even have a 20-year fixed mortgage. The largest that we have is 10. Those, even though they're a much, much shorter term, are still going for 1.99%. I mean, if you were to take our mortgage rates and you were to hop across the ocean and go try to sell these in Denmark, you'd probably be met with a reaction like this. But the real question is, could that happen to Canada? To understand that, we first need to know how Denmark got there in the first place. You see, after 2008, when the mortgage market collapsed and the whole world was in a financial freefall, a lot of investors began to wonder what that would mean for the future of the euro and began looking for a safe haven, something that looked a little bit more stable, something that looked a little bit more certain. And for them, that was the Danish krone. That's basically our Canadian dollar. Now you might be thinking that if you were in Denmark, you'd be saying, wow, this is fantastic. We got the thing that everyone wants, the Danish krone. But there's a problem with that. Denmark, from an export position, has a very similar relationship to the Eurozone that Canada does to the States. You ever wonder why Canada's dollar is always weaker than the American dollar? It's because Canada wants it that way. Because if it remains that way, it's much cheaper for Americans to buy Canadian goods, and that's good for business. So when investors started fleeing to the Danish krone, the value of the Danish krone relative to the euro started to rise. And both the central bank in Denmark and the government realized if we don't do something soon, we're going to have a whole lot less people in Europe buying Denmark exports, and that's going to make a financial crisis worse. You can enact fiscal policy and print more money, thereby increasing the supply of the overall krone and by extension, decreasing the value of it. Or you can enact monetary policy and lower the interest rate. So they decided to do both. And so for the first time in its over 200 years of existence, the central bank in Denmark lowered its rate to the point that it became negative. Meaning if the banks of Denmark wanted to hold their reserves at the central bank, they would have to pay for the privilege to do that. What followed over the next few years was a series of fiscal and monetary adjustments. The central bank maintained their interest rate at under 0%. And so by the time 2019 came, before the effects of a 2020 pandemic, banks in Denmark were actually offering a 10-year mortgage under 0%. In fact, they were offering a negative rate of 0.5%, meaning that as you would make your mortgage payment, banks would pay you. Now, if you're dreaming about what your mortgage payment would be with a 0% or even a negative interest rate, all of the online Canadian mortgage calculators aren't going to be able to help you. Because it turns out that when these calculators were made, most didn't even think that this was a possibility. But now let's come back home to the real question. Could Canada see a mortgage rate of 0%? The Bank of Canada did hint that another rate cut, albeit a small one, could be in Canada's future. But there are a few factors that do limit Canada seeing a 20-year fixed mortgage of 0%. The first is that Canada just isn't set up for longer term mortgages. In fact, as of right now, the longest term that you can get in Canada is a 10-year fixed. And that's predominantly because of Section 10 of the Interest Act. Section 10 of the Canadian Interest Act states this, which is a long-winded and legalese way of saying that anyone who has a mortgage for longer than 5 years only has to pay a 3 months interest-only penalty once they've passed that 5-year mark. This puts a tremendous amount of risk on the lenders for very little reward, and as a result, until that changes, Canadians won't see a loan longer than 10 years. The second is that money has a cost to it. First, banks have to find investors and promise them a return. Then they take that money, package them up as mortgages, and in the process, run up costs to close and originate these mortgages. once the mortgage is funded, there's still cost to service them, so there's cost there, and then on top of all of that, they have to make a profit. So the only way we're going to see interest rates even close to 0% is if the Bank of Canada is willing to go negative in their interest rates. And as we've discussed before, there are two ways of getting out of a financial jam. You can enact fiscal policy and print more money, or you can lower the interest rate with monetary policy. And as we've seen by this government, the arm that they would prefer to flex will most likely be fiscal policy. So expect to see a lot more money printing, and less so on the 0% interest rate side. So is it possible that we could see 0% interest rates in Canada? Yes, but it's highly unlikely. And if it did happen, it wouldn't be for the same reasons as Denmark. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and we'll see you on the next one. If you like the contents of these videos, please consider subscribing, hitting the little bell notification so that you're alerted when new videos come out, and liking it. It goes a long way in supporting a new channel like that, and it would do me a huge favor.